People wonder sometimes how the industrial businesses are changing. And you know, my thoughts always are is you have to look to the consumer businesses today, because it happens there first, and then the expectation comes into the industrial businesses. So just a fun example in my own personal life, you know, if I have a group of people over, and I know somebody's particularly critical about music, I just ask them the name of their favorite song. It's the only thing I'll ask them. I'll plug it into my system, it'll go to the cloud, find all the related songs, and then create a playlist, and I know an hour later that that person was really satisfied, because they'll come back and say, wow, you have great music. Now, if you think about that, that's a cloud-assisted process that I just went through. My phone, my stereo doesn't have all that capability. Back in the cloud, there's a list of all the songs. It's a huge data problem that happens. And so it's done the work from a data scientist standpoint, from a data engineering standpoint, to relate all the songs for that artist, what artists are similar to them, what sound of music it is, what style, what are other songs that fit that same style, and brought that information back to me. And it does it in milliseconds, because it may throw 10,000 computers at it simultaneously. Wouldn't it be great if you're in a manufacturing plant and you have a piece of equipment go down and that information is sent to the cloud, and because the cloud has all the information across the entire ecosystem of people that are using that same equipment, it can very quickly start to diagnose, oh, you're seeing that every 30 seconds. Oh, it's making this type of sound. Here's a 92% chance that this is the problem with that particular piece of equipment. And if you take this action, it's going to resolve it. That's how the world changes, and that's really the direction that we're going with the industrial internet, is to deliver that type of experience in people's everyday work life.